Now, I know it'd be a lot of debate about what wrestling generation is the best wrestling generation. And trust me, I see AEW. Now, the wrestlers today, to me, in my humble opinion, they seem more athletic, more physically inclined. They could probably jump up, grab a sky, bring it down, and hit somebody in the face with it and knock them unconscious. The heel and the hero, they're totally different nowadays. But I'm going to tell you what separated the WWF from the WWE, from the WCW, from the AEW, from the ECW, and everything else. In my day, and I know I sound old, the way the WWF Monday Night Raw used to leave us on cliffhangers, it made no sense. And then we had to wake up on Saturday to look at the recap like we were looking at ESPN to see what was going on. Do you understand how I felt when the pallbearer, all 5'8" of him with no neck, came out there and threatened the Undertaker and said, "Undertaker, remember Undertaker? Remember when you burned that house? There was 3 caskets, Undertaker." And then the entire arena got red and we was like, "Who the hell is coming? Who the hell is coming?" Then all of a sudden, Kane showed up with fire, hell, and brimstone. And do you understand how I felt on Saturday seeing Diesel and then seeing somebody stand behind him just as big as him? Then he turned around and it was a white man with curly blonde hair with muscles on top of his muscles, with shoulders on top of his ass, on top of his shoulders. And he called himself Sid Vicious and he was powerbombing Razor Ramon and he was powerbombing Diesel, who became Kevin Nash. But he was the Diesel before he became Kevin. The storylines, the cliffhangers, us not having as much access to the storylines drove us crazy. When the Generation X came by and they told somebody to suck it. These were grown-ass men, late 20s, early 30s, telling somebody to suck it. I'm a grown man, and I'll do that to my child. I ain't gonna do it to my child. But if he turns his back on me, I'm difficult to go clean your room. I ain't telling him to suck it, but y'all get what I'm saying. When the 1-2-3 kid came out, when Papa Shango was there, when Razor Ramon, the bad guy, if Scarface had a Jerry curl and wore a Speedo, he was Razor Ramon. It was the cliffhangers. It was the lack of access to the storylines in the WWF and the whole thing that kept us so interested. Not saying that our wrestlers, because I hold them near and dear to me, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Bret Hart, Owen Hart, God bless his soul, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, Dink and Doink the Clown. When Dink and Doink the Clown started beefing, I never thought I'd be emotional watching two damn clowns, a tall one and a small one, beef with each other, but I was. Jerry the King Lawler, he talked so much junk, you want him punching in his mouth, then he get in the ring, and he whip ass all through that ring. When Goldust, a man wrapped in a Magnum condom, dipped in gold glitter, would go, when Val Venus was a porn star. It was the lack of access to the storylines that kept us on the edge of our seat. So to the writers, to the entertainers, to the professional wrestlers, to everybody involved in this generation's wrestling, this is me asking you to limit our access to the things we know about what's going to happen. It will bring the excitement back, and I can't wait to be excited like I used to be.